Today we are tackling the repair of the water damage device Oppo Find X2 Lite. Hello guys, I'm Adriana and with the help of Leonardo, I'll guide you through the process we follow in our workshop with the water damage devices. Upon receiving a liquid affected device, our first step is to disconnect the battery to prevent additional damage to the motherboard, as mixing electricity and water can only lead to shorts on the motherboard. Note this step. When you receive a water damage device in your workshop, the first thing to do is to remove the battery connector. Next, we remove the screws of the middle frame using an electric screwdriver. I'll share the purchase link for this tool in the description of the video. It's a tool with thousands of sales worldwide. Once the middle frame is removed, we proceed to inspect the inside of the device to see what surprise it brings. The next step involves disconnecting the three antennas and the main camera module using an anti-static tweezers. It's crucial not to forget the three screws securing the motherboard to the screen frame. If you forget to remove a screw when you are removing the motherboard, it can break in two. Pay attention to this step. Here we have the sub motherboard connector and the screen connector junction. Be careful when removing it. Before handling the motherboard, it's essential to remove the SIM tray. With great care, we remove the motherboard to examine if there is water damage in the components. At the bottom of the device, we find the security label indicating that the device has not been previously opened by third parties. To professionally remove it, heat can be applied and in this way it doesn't break. Subsequently, we unscrew the remaining screws with the star-type screwdriver. We access the audio module, which includes the speaker. We proceed to disconnect the screen connector and the flex cable responsible for transferring information to the motherboard. The next step is to detach the battery to inspect the two flex cables for internal damage. We examine the charging flex, which also includes the charging connector. We finally remove the sub motherboard to carefully inspect it for humidity. We check the charging connector. If it shows no signs of humidity, it's a good sign. In the end, we'll clean this connector with a special product for cleaning electronic components and contacts. On On the motherboard, this label indicates that there has been minimal exposure to humidity, as it has changed color from white to pink, though very slightly. We inspect one of the microphones and notice that heat and humidity have caused the solder to become loose, a side effect of the water. We can observe these solder balls. With the help of an anti-static tweezer, we carefully clean these solder balls. We use a piece of cotton along with contact cleaner to clean all areas affected by humidity, ensuring that are clean. We also clean the charging connector, removing any accumulated residue. We use tweezers to remove all the lint it has. Now we proceed to reassemble the device to evaluate the result of our work. It's important to mention that each water damage device repair is unique and experience plays a crucial role in identifying and solving problems. In our workshop, this type of service costs around 70 euros, which we consider fair considering the operational and tax expenses. Repairing mobile and electronic devices is a field with great potential. And with the high price of advanced devices like Apple Vision Pro glasses, ranging between 3,200 and 3,900 euros, a 500 euros repair might seem insignificant. However, it's necessary to invest in training and specific tools. With a decade of experience, I can assure you that sacrifice and discipline are the keys to achieving quality results. So, get motivated to learn mobile devices repair because this type of business is here to stay for a long time. This job can earn you 50 euros in 5 minutes, but you can also lose an afternoon and end up without a solution. For this reason, large corporations focus mainly on simple repairs that generate significant revenue. Thanks to their high volume of work, they can afford to discard more complex cases. Herein lies our opportunity to take on those challenges and commit to acquiring more and more knowledge. This approach positions us as specialized in mobile repair and allows us to provide solutions where others can't, reinforcing our value in the market. So go for it and start learning to repair mobile devices. Thanks to YouTube, training is practically for free. Many years ago, I spent thousands and thousands of euros on training and some tools directly from China, so take advantage of this moment. If you like this type of content, please don't forget to give a big like. Thank you. Using a USB tester, we confirm that the Oppo charges correctly at 1.9 amperes, indicating optimal operation. We perform additional tests to ensure that the device responds 100%. It seems that the device is working 100% and with very little effort we have managed to solve this issue. Many devices have easy solution, but sometimes things get complicated and you need to rely on experience. This kind of experience is gained over time. is not the same to repair 50 devices as it is to repair 1000, so to speak. Guys, here's Leonardo, we hope you liked this video, and until next time, bye bye!